Hi Aries, Mary here with your weekly reading. This is for the week of April 16th through the 22nd. And I went ahead and pulled some tarot cards, just three tarot cards. And we'll do some angel cards and oracle cards after that. But I just pulled the three and I thought I'd do just immediate past, the present, and then the future. So the first card up that I pulled for you, Aries, is Four of Cups. So what this card says to me is you're either being introspective, or it could mean that you're being a little you have been a little self-absorbed lately. But you see that this person has three cups that are full. They're in the upright position, but they're not paying attention to those cups. They want the cup that's just kind of out of reach that they're looking for. So you may be a little self-absorbed and you don't see what it is that you have. Like, you don't see what you really have. You're just busy looking at what you want, if that makes sense. And the next card up is Seven of Wands. So that's how you were feeling in the immediate past, but in the present, this week of April 16th, you really need to stand your ground. This is the Seven of Wands, and it's all about action. So you want to take a stand in something, stand your ground in something. There might be a situation this coming week where, yeah, you just need to stand your ground, stand firm, stand in your power. Okay, but the future, the immediate future, is the Star card. And this is a great card to get. It's all about feeling hope for the future, balance, harmony, serenity, that kind of feeling. So I feel like if you, Aries, if you kind of have gratitude for what it is that you do have, try not to get too self-absorbed. And stand up for what it is that you believe in, stand in your power, that will bring hope and inspire you to move forward for the future. Okay, so we'll pull some angel cards. This is Angel Prayers by Kyle Gray. And we'll just pull a few cards for you here, Aries. Okay, so you want to take a leap of faith. So, whatever you're thinking about, as you look towards your future, don't be afraid to take that leap. Know that Spirit has your back. You're being supported. You're being divinely supported. So, you know, make sure you do the homework, but I think that you can take that leap. And the next card I got is Time to Go. So this can mean a few things. It could mean that it's, you know, there's a move taking place, or it could be just that you need to move forward. So not actually like physically move, although that could be. Also could mean travel. But basically, know that with every ending is a new beginning. So take that leap of faith and don't be afraid to move forward, because a new beginning is on the horizon for you. And you've got the Star card, so really you can't go wrong with that, Aries. Okay, this is Wisdom of the Oracle. Round and round. You see that? The number is 25. 2 plus 5 adds up to 7. Now this card can connotate that you feel like you're going around and around in circles, right? So you're taking like two steps forwards, but then you take a step back. But the number 7 means that you're on the right path, and it could be a spiritual path. So I feel like you need to just continue the way that you are headed, Aries. As long as you stand in your power, that seems really important. and there's no place like home. So maybe you, here we go. Maybe you do have a move. Maybe there is a move. Maybe you are moving somewhere physically, to a new home. But remember, home is always where the heart is, right? And the number is 5. So 5 connotates change. So there may be a change coming up as you move forward, standing your ground with gratitude, knowing that, you know, your cups are pretty full here. You have what you need. Just stand your ground, stand in your truth, stand in your power, and it's going to be a good week for you, Aries. Okay, I hope that this was helpful for you in some small way. If so, please like, subscribe, and share. And I look forward to your comments below. Thanks so much. Take care.